This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, I'm going to go over what a reference angle is and how to find them. Here's the definition. This is formal. The reference angle of a given angle is the positive acute angle formed by the terminal side of a non-quadrantal angle in the x-axis. So we're looking for an acute angle. So we're looking for something between 0 and 90 degrees. And we're going to look at the terminal side of the angle and the x-axis to find our little acute angle. All right, so if the angle is already acute, that's the answer. Okay, so for instance, the reference angle of 40 degrees, okay, well, if I'm going to take this definition and I'm going to do 40 degrees, right, we know this is 40 degrees, it's saying what angle does that make with the x-axis? Okay, well, it's 40 degrees still, right? So the reference angle of 40 degrees is 40 degrees. So usually it doesn't make sense to ask for a reference angle for something that already is acute. So let's look at another problem here. Find the reference angle of 160 degrees. So we want to see where that is. Where is 160 degrees? Well, it's over in this quadrant, right? So if this is 160 degrees, right now here's the trick. You have to form the angle between the terminal side, here's the terminal side of 160 degrees, and the x-axis. You always want to find an angle with the x-axis, not with a y-axis. Make sure you're looking here. So the question is, what is this angle here? Well, I know if this is 160, all the way to the x-axis would be 180 degrees. So it's always just the difference of those two numbers. All right? So however many degrees it is at the x-axis, right? And the reference angle you've got. So in this case, we've got 160 and we've got 180. You just subtract the bigger number minus the smaller. So 180 degrees. Minus 160 degrees equals 20 degrees. So that is your reference angle. That is the angle formed by the terminal side and the x-axis. All right, let's try these. Find the reference angle of 320 degrees. Okay, so where's that? Let's see, I think I want to use a black. So where is 320 degrees? All right, so it's somewhere over here, okay? 320 degrees, or if you want, you could write 320 degrees. That might be easier for you to write it over here. It's up to you. What do we want to do? We always want to find the angle that forms with the x-axis, okay? So here's the x-axis, here's the y-axis. We want this angle. Make sure you don't do this angle over here. Do not do it with the y-axis. It has to be with the x-axis. All right, so how many degrees would this be? Well, it's got to be a number between 0 and 90, right? So I have to think, well, all the way over here is 360 degrees if I kept going. So I just subtract those two numbers, bigger minus smaller. 360 minus 320 degrees equals 40 degrees, and that is our answer. All right, let's try 250. All right, so where is 250 degrees? Okay, that's over here in quadrant 3 somewhere. So let's say that's how far you have to go to do the 250 degrees. Again, you want to find out what acute angle that makes with the x-axis, so we want this acute angle right here. Remember, we want a positive acute angle. So how many degrees is it over to here on the x-axis? It would be 180 degrees, so we just subtract. It's the difference of the bigger and smaller number. So of course we want to do the bigger number first. 250 minus 180 equals 70 degrees. And that is our reference angle. So basically, if you have something in between 0 and 360, all right, that's not already acute, you're either going to subtract it from 180 or do 180 minus the angle, or you're going to subtract it from 360, as in this problem A right here. But if it's more than 360 to begin with, you want to first just find out the coterminal angle that's in between 0 and 360. So let's do that. Find the reference angle of 860 degrees. Well, first of all, this is more than 360 degrees, so let's find the coterminal angle. Okay, so first, find the coterminal angle. And I want it to be between 0 and 360 degrees, okay? So how do we do that? How do you find the coterminal angle? You can just either subtract or add 360 degrees till you get the range you want. So in this case, I could subtract 360. It's 500, all right, and that's still more than 360, so I could subtract 360 again. Get 140 degrees. Now, somebody else may have gotten it a little bit quicker. They would have said, well, I know that subtracting 360 is not going to do it, so I'm going to do two 360s. You could subtract 720. All at once, you're still going to get reference angle. So it's the same, to find the reference angle for 860, it's the same as finding the reference angle of 140, because the terminal side is in the same place. Remember, coterminal angles have the terminal side ending in the same place. So now we're going to do 140. So where is 140? That terminal side, and that's what really matters. Oops. Where the terminal side, oops, sorry, cancel. Here we go. So where's 140? All right, well, that's less than 180 degrees, so it's here, right? I'm going to say that's 140 degrees, let's say. And we want to find the angle that makes with the x-axis. It's always the acute angle with the x-axis. So what's that going to be? Well, all the way over is 180. So we just subtract the two numbers. Bigger minus smaller will always do it. Now, I'm sure most of you could do this in your head. If it's 140 to here, you could figure out there's 40 more degrees to get to the x-axis here. All right, let's try this one. Find the reference angle of negative 50 degrees. Again, our first step is to find the coterminal angle. Find a coterminal angle. In 0, 360. So we're going to look for a positive angle in between 0 and 360. So if I have negative 50 degrees, let's see, I could just add 360 once and I'll have it. So what's 360 minus 50? That's 310 degrees. So since these are coterminal, you know the terminal side is going to be in the same place. And where is 310 degrees? Well, it's somewhere over here, right? And I always want to see what angle that forms with the x-axis right here. Now, you know, if I went all the way to here, it'd be 360. So it's just the difference between 360 and 310. Hopefully you can do that in your head. That ends up being 50 degrees. Now, you might have figured that out without finding the coterminal angle. You might have said, well, I'm going to go negative 50 degrees. That's down here. So you could, most people could figure out that is a 50 degree angle that forms there. All right, so if you actually have something like negative some number less than 90, if you just take off the minus sign, you'll have it because of that reason. Now the reason people use reference angles is something different. They use it so they can compute without thinking about whether the sine, cosine, or tangent is negative till the end of the problem. Okay? So I don't actually use reference angles myself. I just always draw the picture and figure it out from the picture. But I'll do some problems like that on the next video. One last thing I want to say is that if you look in most trig books and they explain the reference angle, they make it much more complicated. It's really just the angle formed between that angle and the x-axis. And if you visualize it, it's much easier to see what it's going to be. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.